halfway across the world, give people an introduction to our company, Novonix, and an update on some of our key activities over the last little while here. So if we go to the next slide, this is just our general disclaimer, so I encourage everyone to take a look at it offline. This presentation has been posted to the ASX. So on the next slide, gives an overview of the company. So Novonix is a diversified battery materials and technology company with three operating units within our umbrella. So everything is under our listed entity of Novonix Limited on the ASX. And we also have an application lodged to list on the North American OTC market, which should go through later this month after our annual report has been released. So our company is really focused on advancing battery technologies and materials for the future of lithium-ion batteries, long-life lithium-ion batteries that will support electric vehicles and grid energy storage. And our three operating units consist of our battery technology solution business, our pure graphite anode material business, and our newest entry, which is working on cathode materials. And we'll talk a little bit about each of those. So our battery technology solutions business was founded in 2013, really works on equipment technologies and demonstrating performance of materials with R&D tools that we've developed to take research and development cycles from months or years down to weeks. We have a partnership with the university here at Dalhousie University working on advanced materials, and we have full pilot line capabilities. We build batteries, full scale batteries in-house, and do the design, testing, and prototyping. And through this unit, we provide that equipment and services to all the leading battery manufacturers and OEMs around the world and have sales and services in over 15 countries. And continue to develop IP such as our dry particle microgranulation technology, which we've given some previous presentations about, which have really led to this new cathode technology. Spun out of this ecosystem where we use our technology business to develop and validate materials really was our first commercial opportunity of pure graphite. So pure graphite was founded in 2017, focused on bringing long life synthetic graphite to the market from the United States. And in the short period from when we started the business in 2017 till now, we've signed the conditional sales contract with our material around with Samsung SDI and a non-binding MOU with Sanyo, both of which we've announced in the past 12 months. And we'll go into this business in a lot more detail, but our goal here is to bring to market and deliver on high performance material to support vehicles and energy storage. And the newest entry to our business units is our cathode material business. And so this is being spun out of our battery technology solutions business with intellectual property that was developed in partnership with the university on lower cost processing technologies to make cathode materials. We've now invested in bringing that technology to pilot scale. We filed multiple patents around the technology, really entry-level patents to how to do this new technique and breakthroughs around single crystal materials. And these are NMC and NCA type materials. And we'll get into why those are important in a minute. So if we look at the next slide, this is really showing the market and why we're here. So it's clear that lithium-ion batteries and energy storage are the path of the future, especially for electrification of vehicles and the grid. And so this really shows the uptick in electric vehicle adoption that's coming over the course of this decade and onward, and what that really means for battery manufacturing demand. So through the course of this decade, battery manufacturing will move to 2 terawatt hours of capacity or more. And all of that relies on the materials. And all of this demand is being driven by, as you can see in this middle figure, almost primarily from passenger vehicles, and then commercial and stationary storage. So consumer electronics, which used to be a huge portion of the market, is about to be dwarfed by the demands for vehicles and energy storage systems. And the demands for vehicle and energy storage systems are much higher than that for consumer electronics. Cell phones and laptops can get away with lasting a couple of years, but batteries for electric vehicles and energy storage systems have to last 10, 20 plus years for the economics to work. And so bringing materials to the market that are lower cost and higher performance is a critical path in continuing to accelerate the adoption of these technologies. And so the figure on the right shows some of the critical materials and how much of them will be needed as production is ramped up. But when you look at the anode and the cathode, or the positive and or the negative and positive electrode of the battery system, and today that represents about a $10 billion market. Those are the two most expensive components of the cell. And over the course of this decade, that will grow to a $100 billion market. So that is really where our activities are focused, is in trying to bring advanced materials into that critical market to drive adoption of these technologies. So if you look at the next slide, what's really exciting about the battery industry today is that growth is finally happening outside of Asia. So this chart gives a bit of an outline of the US announced capacities with folks from LG Chem, Panasonic and Sanyo, SK Innovations, all partnering with automotive companies to install production capacity of battery cells in the United States. And so this has about 100 gigawatt hours of capacity to come online in the United States by 2023. And more will be announced. And for example, this doesn't have Tesla's new facility that they announced in Austin, Texas earlier this year. But the story is even stronger in Europe, where they're expecting almost 200 gigawatt hours over that time scale and have indicated more than 400 gigawatt hours in the pipeline. And so the reason that this is so important is that we're now at a time where battery manufacturing is moving outside of Asia, and thus the supply chain needs to be able to move with it. And so these companies are looking to build diversified supply chains that no longer rely almost exclusively on China as they do today. And so if you look at the next slide, what's very important for all of these technologies in vehicles especially, and it's caught the attention of the media over the last number of months, is this quest for the so-called million mile battery. So can we develop battery technologies that can support a vehicle driving 1 million miles? And when you look at a passenger vehicle requirement, of course, that's huge. Not many people plan to put 1 million miles on a vehicle. But when you really look at the implication longer term, million mile batteries are going to be those that can support energy storage and these even higher demand applications, where the amount of energy storage required to transition the grid to renewable sources will vastly outweigh the electric vehicle fleet over the coming decades. So all of these materials have to be able to support lower cost and higher performance. And so there's three critical elements in the battery that are going to dictate the life and performance of the cell. And this is the anode or negative electrode, the cathode or positive electrode, and the electrolyte system, which shuttles ions in between and reacts with both of those electrodes. And so when you look at Novonix's technology, we really work across all three of these critical areas of battery performance. Our pure graphite anode has now been proven, qualified with Samsung. It's developed and it's scaling production now, and we'll speak more about that in a second. On the cathode side, this is, as I said, a new opportunity with IP that we've just filed and is under development. We're investing in taking that technology to pilot scale now, where we can look to demonstrate the performance improvements and lower cost opportunities there. And all the while, we work on electrolyte systems and are filing our first patents around advanced electrolyte systems that can support these long life applications. And so on the next slide really shows why these are important. The blue dashed line shows kind of commercial reference of NMC or nickel manganese cobalt positive electrode versus graphite, and equivalent driving miles that these technologies can achieve. And so you can see that that technology can achieve maybe 200,000 or a little less equivalent driving miles, and some assumptions on the chart. When you move to a single crystal cathode technology, you can see you can break that 500,000 equivalent driving miles barrier. And then you can start using things like advanced electrolyte systems shown in purple, which are those that we're filing IP around. And you can see you can surpass 1 million miles of equivalent driving on these projected lines. And a huge benefit comes from switching the commercial graphite to a pure graphite material. And this is really what has people like Samsung and Sanyo excited about our opportunity to bring these materials to market outside of Asia, where we can demonstrate the performance of these to far exceed these million mile aspirations. And so on the next slide is an update about what we've done corporately recently. So in June, we completed a $63 million equity raise and restructuring. And this is really to support the next growth phase of the business. This transaction redeemed all of our convertible notes, repaid our unsecured loans, and has now provided funding to expand Pure Graphite's facility to 2,000 tons per year over the next 2 years and continue to invest in our cathode technology and taking that to pilot and hopefully beyond to demonstrate the performance of that material. And so a primary focus right now is on expanding our Pure Graphite plant and fulfilling our agreements with Samsung and Sanyo and looking to build long-term supply relationships there. So the next slide gives a bit of a direct update on Pure Graphite itself. So the mass production line, we've had some delays through the course of this year around COVID with some equipment, and our plant was shut down around in the state of Tennessee when emergency states were issued. But it's now fully operational after commissioning and optimization, and so we are starting to make material regularly to fulfill these obligations under our agreements. Our Samsung SDI contract, our first shipments will go to Samsung in this month, and multiple has been scheduled over the next 6 months. We've been working very closely with the Samsung team around our delivery schedule, our supply audits, our qualifications, as well as Samsung's timing for their cell production. So the cell format that they are building with the Pure Graphite material will now start its mass production in April of 2021. And so we will be supplying material leading into that cell production date in early next year. So then our Sanyo agreement, the MOU that we've signed with Sanyo is really to evaluate the mass production samples, and we've been working with their team. And now that the line is operational and samples are being qualified, they're going to be delivered to Sanyo for further evaluation and then working toward a potential supply agreement with them. And while we talk a lot about Samsung and Sanyo as these public relationships that we have, of course, we have a number of other customers under development, samples issued to numerous potential customers under confidentiality agreements. And we continue to expand our engagements with other cell manufacturers, auto OEMs, and energy storage-focused companies now that we're increasing our bandwidth of production at Pure Graphite. And while having a qualified product and expanding our production is a critical path and a huge accomplishment for the business, investing in our technology and development still remains a key priority. So our product and technology development roadmap has us scaling our relationships in our supply chain, both on the materials and the equipment side, developing new partners and new technology, and as well working on those new products with those folks, and internally on our process conditions and any improvements we can have. And new materials are coming from our production facility in Tennessee to our R&D center in Halifax, Nova Scotia, to be tested in full-scale cells all the time. And so why people are interested in our material, and I don't have time to go through the full chart, but we have a high energy density material on the next slide, sorry, with a very long cycle life, moderate cost, very high safety and purity, and very low chemical emissions due to our process. And one of these critical elements is that we offer supply diversification. Currently, the market relies on Asia and specifically China to source all of these materials, and they are looking for opportunities to develop supply chain outside of China, and that's what we're offering. So the next slide shows our phased growth plan for Pure Graphite over the course of this decade. As I said, we've just raised the capital required for this phase one ramp to 2,000 tons per year. And then through the middle of the 2025, we want to be scaling to 25,000 tons, then 100,000 tons at the end of the decade. And of course, we can accelerate these timelines on the back of contracts and further agreements with the folks that we're working with. And so the last slide in conclusion, Novonix is really delivering battery materials focused on the vehicle and renewable sector. We're redefining manufacturing processes to deliver lower cost, higher performance materials, and have competencies across the entire cell technology platform. Strong relationships with auto OEMs and battery manufacturers help us get in and qualify our products quickly, and we've demonstrated the performance of these technologies with more to come. Our first commercial technology in pure graphite is now under contract, and this is the only comp we're the only company to have broken into this market outside of Asia. And our cathode technology is entering pilot scale, and it has an opportunity to be bigger than our anode business.